naked. I'm gonna...
I am not a crook. I tell you, my friend, I am not a crook. And when I am not going to show you my plans.
She packs her stuff inside a yellow bag. She realizes this is the last. With her mother, with her father, who's told her yellow lies her whole life. Her yellow dreams, her yellow hair, her yellow dresses all prepared. Her bodies, no one will notice her absence when she's gone. She sits inside her taxi cab. There's no going back, there's no looking back. To the place knocked off the track, yeah. She sits inside her, never gonna find her. Says she's gonna go away, even though that might be really sad to say, yeah.
It's time once again for the Who Cares podcast.
Oh my god, who the hell cares?
That's right, who cares? Who cares? I care because you know what? We all care, and I know you care because it's time you're listening because you know that we said it's a bonus week. It's a bonus episode. And the bonus episode is this episode. And it is all about Octi, our new VP of What's the Play Games. And he will be streaming live on twitch.tv/What's the Play Games. Coming to you. And he's going to be playing Overwatch and Fortnite. And this episode is totally dedicated to this man's talents. And we have right here the man that introduced it all, Pokey John.
How you doing, Steven? What are you up to?
Well, I'm just recording this on a very early morning here, yeah, but I had a rough night last night.
Did you? What happened?
I was following you guys on Twitch, and I was really sad for you because it sounds like you lost your girlfriend.
Oh yeah, I did lose my girlfriend. For all those people that are subscribed to us on Twitch, What's to Play Games. If you're not, I mean, geez, you better get to that site, twitch.tv/What's to Play Games, to subscribe. Because, I mean, if you don't, you're going to miss all these great things that we have to offer.
And also, they might be able to find that missing person.
Yeah, they might be able to help me find my girlfriend. I need people to see what's going on in the background to tell me when something's going on that I don't see.
That's right.
So, they definitely have that chat window to tell me what's going on and, let me know where Team Rocket's at, because I think they're behind it.
You know what? I was watching you guys, yesterday on twitch.tv/What's Play Games, and I saw that you found a clue at the very end of the,
I did. I found this dude's hat.
Oh my god.
His face mask. So, I got the scent. I can get my Houndar to, direct me to... right where she's at, and they don't even know it yet, so I'm one step ahead.
I hope that they're not doing anything very... I hope they're not violating her.
Oh my god, if they are, then I'm going to have to take one down one at a time. Slowly but surely, I will find her.
They are evildoers.
Super evil.
Ugh, Team Rocket. Yeah. Well, hopefully you get to find her. Do you really want to find her, though? Are you feeling better without her?
No, she's...
she means a lot.
I'm not eating as much, so when I need to get this woman, my nutrient levels are
just, your minerals?
Yeah, my mineral levels are just, they're getting, it's running low. I'm running on my reserves.
Well, speaking of minerals, actually not speaking of minerals, we're here today to celebrate Day Space Dream, who's going to be playing under the What's Play banner on twitch.tv/What's Play Games. And he comes from a very long lineage of gamers. Or no. Or has he started the lineage?
No. I mean, Octi's definitely a great gamer, you know. Like, I met him skateboarding and whatnot. And
how long have you known
Call
him?
Call of Duty. Oh. Like, I've known him like 12, 13 years. So, I mean, me and him have gone through a lot of things and know each other really well. And he's just a great... first-person shooter player. Like, at first it started out with just Deathmatch and things like that, but now he's playing Fortnite and Overwatch, which have tons of other objectives and stuff like that. And he's great at holding the team together and just directing them to win. So he's definitely a great person to watch. And I know that he's almost a diamond status or something like that. I'm not sure exactly.
Yeah, and it seems like he's in every category. He's like, not every, but a lot of the big categories there on Fortnite, he's already getting like number one. Mm-hmm. And it's a pleasure for him to be aboard with us. And not only that, his personality is sparkling.
Yeah, that's exactly why we hang out together, because we can just build off on each other's funniness, and people end up pissing their pants over us, because we don't give them a second to take a rest, man. It's just boom, boom, boom.
So we had a chance to sit down with Mr. Dayspace Dream. You can follow him on Twitch, Dayspace Dream, but also he's going to be playing under the What's to Play banner, being the VP of What's to Play Games, and I hopefully you'll be able to see all the chicanery.
Yeah, I mean, you won't miss tomfoolery if you follow us. So
that's right. Just subscribe. You can also please follow us on the Gram, What's to Play app, or Twitter, What's to Play app, and then also they can follow you on Twitter.
Yeah, PokeJohn. All they have to do is search that, and they'll find me.
He's tearing it up out there, and we still have a gentleman over here that do you know Octi? Our producer over here?
Yeah, no, Octavius, good dude.
Good dude. See, three people now, all of a sudden, vouching. So you follow us, please. And ladies and gentlemen, I want to make sure that you understand that this is kind of an inside look at the future of the world, basically. Octi is your first-hand look into the future. If you're worried about your kids, if you're worried about your sister, if you're worried about yourself, don't worry. Octi's got you. He's a first-person player.
Yeah, he'll keep you safe. I mean, he knows how to use a gun, and he knows how to take names. And
he's doing it all for good. So
exactly.
Here we go. Ladies and gentlemen, here's our interview with Mr. Dayspace Dream under the What's to Play banner. Enjoy.
Swinging in the backyard, pull up in your fast car, whistling my name. Open up a beer and you say get over here and play a video game. I'm in his favorite sundress, watching me get undressed, take that body downtown. I say you the bestest, leaning for a big kiss, put his favorite perfume on, go play a video game.
We're here live, ladies and gentlemen. Welcome again to the Who Cares
Paul. Who cares?
Who does really care? We're here live with Octi Orizaba. Thank you for joining us, my man.
Guys, thanks for coming in. Welcome. Octi Orizaba, Xbox Live name is Dayspace Dream. Known over a couple podcasts, and we're here to get the party started, guys. Let's get it going.
And we're so excited to have you here because, you know, we've known each other for a little bit. And what I saw was that you had an amazing amount of talent. Man, it's fantastic. So I kind of want to welcome to the Who Cares podcast.
Guys, I really appreciate you having me. This is a big time deal. And I mean, it's a proud to be part of this number, you know, what they would say.
Exactly. And, you know, you've been friends with my friend, John the Fisherman, who's now going by Pokemon John.
Definitely. So me and Poke John have gone back since day one, man. We've been in
Poke John,
Mooners, numerous amounts of bands together. We play music. We're all musicians. Like, I come from a line of playing guitar, doing your own thing, making shit fucking the best that you can do, and we go back. Me and John have known each other. I love his whole family. It's a good time deal, and that's the boy right there. That's the guy to know.
And he's the guiding light. And so I'm glad that he brought us together, and we're also here with Shane, who's taking some fantastic footage right now.
Shane is our live enthusiast right now, so thanks, absolutely, Shane, for taking us live.
And I just feel so seeing the transition from just a simple app, now we're going into What's Play Games and whatnot, and nobody better than to have you here with us, because exactly. I think you're number one on pretty much every category.
Yeah, I mean,
in Fortnite.
Right now.
In Overwatch.
Yeah, definitely. Right now in Fortnite, I'm sitting at number one on top number of solo score, top number 25 placements, and top 10 placements, guys. So we're definitely starting the podcast and starting the company out. You know, a little something good. You got the top guy in every division right now. So we're going to play it by ear and do as good as we can, right?
That's right. So everybody out there, if you want to come to the best, come to What's Play Games.
Exactly.
So, again, it's a pleasure to have you here. My name is Steven, Steven with a PH. Again, everybody knows that. But we don't have our lady, Miss Southern Belle, Miss Meg Lee. She's out and about doing her thing, Woman of the Night. I mean, that's terrible, terrible reference, but I'm just kidding. She's out doing her thing tonight.
You're as good as you can be, yeah.
I was playing. So, but right now we have you, and we want to show the world, but we also want the world to understand you as a person. Definitely. And kind of see where you came from. We're here in the mean streets of Anaheim, but he lives on the hill looking over the mean streets of Anaheim. But in saying that, we're here in Anaheim, here with you, Octi, and maybe basically if you could kind of enlighten our audience, where you kind of came from and what kind of has been the transition, how you basically what goes on in your life, where you came from, and how you got to this particular place in your life today.
Definitely, guys. Basically, it all started from me being a kid and getting introduced to video games. My brother was very much into beating me when I was a kid, so I feel like I wanted to get really good as a youngster. We used to play FIFA 98 all the fucking time, and he would beat me countless, and I would think about, like, what can I do to beat this guy, because he's beating me every fucking time.
Mm.
Eventually, it came to the point where I started beating him, and he started asking me for pointers, so it came towards the point of me having the love of video games, the love of just dedication, being better at things that you know you can be.
I think that's kind of a theme throughout your life. What's to Play Games? Mm-hmm. That's been kind of the theme throughout your life, is that everything that you kind of tackle, you always try to be the best. That's pretty much been the constant theme throughout this.
Definitely. I mean, it started off with video games. Everybody plays video games in their life. I mean, Super Nintendo was a big part of me growing up, you know, Mario Kart, Zelda, all that type of stuff. We'll get into more of, like, the video games that I started to play a little bit later in the podcast. But coming into that, like, just the competitive spirit, like, being better than the person next to you. And a lot of people ask this question, like, how are you so good or why are you so good? And the only thing that people really need to concentrate on is being better than the person next to you.
That's right.
And it's as long as you grow on that, you know, motto and that mindset, then it's going to come easy. I mean,
but I think in saying that, I think that you're open though to learning, because you can't, it's not just about like, oh, beating this person, beating that person. Mm-hmm. I think that you're also very open to like, oh, what can this person show me? It's not, you know, you don't want to crush the first individual that
exactly,
comes.
Exactly. Yeah, right? Yeah. Yeah. It's more about like learning off everybody who plays this game is good at something. And if you can adapt to everybody's, you know, like I'm good at this and I'm good at that, then you're just going to really be that type of like sponge, that umbrella that really incorporates everybody into something. And this whole thing is about just bringing the community together, being a part of something that's bigger than something else. Video games are a huge part of fucking, like, we reach people that are fucking through the masses. Right now, we're like 30 million viewers on Overwatch. Fortnite has like 100 million viewers on Twitch. Like, it's a big time part to be a part of something. And right now, it's the place to be, my dudes.
Absolutely. Because, you know, looking at this, if you go to twitch.tv, What's to Play Games, and Octi will be the main man on there. Whether it be through just streaming or we're actually going to see him out live and about too in certain points. And just maybe we'll have a different couple talk shows or whatnot, including this motherfucker here. And so what I want to make sure of that is that the world knows that, like, I think they could kind of take a little bit from your mindset and kind of just see. And I think that's the main thing to take away. Anybody that's listening to this, just kind of listen to his mindset, whether it be games, whether it be if you're also a fantastic disc golfer. Mm-hmm. And each one of those things, maybe some people out there, wow, he disc golfs or he plays video games. Well, you know what? He's the best at what he does. So you can't take that away from that man. And so I don't know if you're the best at what you, it doesn't matter what you do. If you're a plumber, if you're if you're a carpenter, whatever the case may be, just be the best. Exactly. Or at least try to be. And you're going to be 10 times better than you were before.
I mean, striving to be the greatest is one of the fucking best things you can look forward to. It's not making anybody feel like little or making anybody feel like not their worth. It's about you striving to be the most optimistic and best person that you can be on and off the court. I mean, you know, like it, sports is almost the same thing as video games. I mean, you're playing against a bunch of people. You're doing what you can do, mm-hmm. and you're trying to be the best Absolutely. That you can be. And somebody else is going to be better than you, but you striving to be better than them, and you finally beating them and winning a match against them is a feeling that is uncounted for, and something that you can really set your mind towards.
Right, and it's like you said. I think the main takeaway too is it's not like you want to hurt the other people, but if you try to be the best you can, then it gives you the opportunity to give back to other people and teach and learn. I mean, if you're a dickhead and you're the best, mm-hmm. well, that guy probably is not going to teach you.
Exactly.
You know what I mean? But the kind of person that you are, it kind of you're willing to like show, you know, because if you feel the confidence, if you have the things to back it up, then you're able to give back to everyone else.
The thing about this, man, is that there's so many people on this planet that you can't just think about like individualists and right. being your own person.
There
you gotta make people grow. The way we make this shit happen is by making shit grow, man. Like
absolutely.
Every time, anything that you do can help somebody else, and you trying to do something better towards the world is just gonna help somebody else. You never know what somebody's going through. If someone needs to come here for a good time, for advice, for whatever, like you don't always need to push this like I'm better than everybody else thing. It's more about like
right.
let's let each other grow and see where it brings us, really.
And that's the whole thing. All the people that are coming together under the What's Play banner are all the same type of mindset, because we've seen there's fucking dickheads out there. And if you're listening to it, don't be that big of a dickhead, okay, guys? Just understand that people are trying to, they're just like you. They're trying to get out there and they're trying to live their life and trying to find their way in the world. And maybe, just maybe, we'll be able to help them and help them grow as people. So let's get off that topic and let's go straight into where have you been with games? And I want to ask you one of the main questions here. Let's start off with this. What are your five favorite games?
Wow. Okay. So currently my five favorite games are...
Of all time.
Of all time? Okay.
Yeah.
Wow. Of all time.
Of all time.
Okay.
Of all time.
Because
we might have some...
Okay.
Some old...
Let's go all time favorite video games.
Yeah, let's do it.
So first of all, I'm going to start with the first game that I ever owned and got really good at. It was The Legend of Zelda, A Link to the Past.
I love...
Classic NES game. Over the top type of player strategic game. If you know video games, you know Zelda, and you know where the fuck that comes from.
Absolutely.
So, I mean, it's about surviving as long as you can, figuring out strategic puzzles and stuff like that. Zelda goes back to the NES, and it's one of the best fucking...
I still have it.
One of the best establishments of any type of video game ever. So I'm going to start with there. I put so many hours into that game when I was freaking 10 years old.
I feel you. You know what's crazy about Zelda, or any video game from the past?
Mm-hmm.
I don't know if you've experienced this or not,
mm-hmm.
but it's kind of like a song, like, you know, when you were dating a girl or whatnot. But I literally went and played, I still have a couple of NES systems or whatnot. And I played it, and all of a sudden, all these thoughts from, like, when I was in 7th grade,
mm-hmm.
it was like it automatically came just because I was looking at this particular screen, or just because... Oh,
one of these guys.
Look at that.
One of these guys.
Dust that bitch off.
When you hit the reset button, you gotta blow
right?
it in there and give it a little kiss or something like that.
See?
This is what I started on. This is where Legend of Zelda was built for me.
Look at that. That's
it's a
look at the Super
test
NES
of time. Still beautiful as fuck right here.
Still solid.
Someone just posted a Bonk's Adventure on TurboGrafx-16.
Oh, wow,
hey,
Bonk's Adventure.
Dang.
You know, she might have been, or he might have been, the only person to have TurboGrafx-16, but
Jimmy
do remember.
Jimmy Towner.
Oh, Jimmy Jimmy Towner, of course.
Hey, Jimmy, thanks for listening, my man.
Absolutely.
Welcome.
Yeah, actually, Jimmy Towner was the first, the number one fan of the Who Cares podcast, and he has a shirt, all the ones that we're wearing. But no, he's an intelligent individual, and he might just show up one of these days on the Who Cares podcast. But yeah, wow, Bonk's Adventure, Jesus Christ. I don't know how long that game system was out for, but it came at the same time as Genesis.
Mm-hmm. 16-bit games came and went, and they
right.
really didn't last that long.
That's right.
I mean, 18-bit was
it went 64 like that, right?
Yeah.
And so now we have this, porn meets
the
streaming. Right? So... Well, so we have Legend of Zelda, or I'm sorry, what's the one for Super Nintendo? Was
The Legend of Zelda, A Link to the Past.
A Link to the Past. So that would be number one.
Exactly. I'm going to kind of bring you in like chronological order from
That's
like
good.
Where I started from and where I went to. The next video game that I absolutely loved, and I think everybody can agree with me, is Super Mario World. It was one of the fucking most outrageous fucking out of its time type of fucking gameplay. You had Mario, you had Yoshi, you had Luigi, you had fucking like 18 different Yoshi. Worlds that you can fucking get into, bro. You had your fucking... After you were done with the game, you're like, I'm done with the game. You're like, no, there's like star levels to go through. So the fact, like, the progression, the fact that you're not done yet is something that I was really about. That's why I like Zelda. Like, I can easily beat a game. I've had countless amount of games where I've beaten in one day. Like, Xbox One games, PS4 games, all these games that come out and focus on graphics, but they don't nearly come to the point or touch anything that Zelda or Mario has done. The reason why is because the longevity of the game, dude. Mm-hmm. You play a game and you're done with it in a day. How does that That's terrible. Never going to remember that game.
Absolutely.
But a game that you go back and you play a fucking 100 times, and literally, you saw the console. I still have the console here. Yeah. I'm still playing these fucking games.
Yeah, you're like, right. When I beat Zelda, I actually felt like I literally accomplished
something. Yeah, it's like, dude, you did something. You spent hours into this game and like commitment and time, and you saw the princess die a bunch of fucking times, and you come into this temple and you lose and you lose and you lose. And
you had to drink so many elixirs.
Right? Elixirs on deck. Don't worry.
That's a new shirt
Final Fantasy is coming, because it's definitely part of my fucking shit.
But... I think that's a new shirt coming out from What's Play Games. Elixirs on deck.
Dude. Batter up, baby.
So we got Super Mario. One thing about Super Mario World, why is Yoshi always the most maneuverable? He's always the shit.
Yeah. Yoshi is the best because he is a fucking dinosaur, and dinosaurs rip, bro. Rest in peace.
Wow, I never... All right, so what's your on that note? What's your third fucking game?
All right, we're gonna take a walk down the center lane? Aisle here, right? Yeah. So we started on SNES. That was basically my first console, like basically killing two birds with one stone. I started playing games there. I had my two favorite games there easily, one of the top. Not to skip a couple stones, but to get into something else and starting to get into like the new generation, which is like my real generation. Which is PlayStation. My favorite fucking game from PlayStation was Final Fantasy VII. Wow. And the reason why, I still have it right here. Let me show you guys a copy. Like, yeah, all these things, like when things stick to you, you're gonna understand what happens. So Final Fantasy VII, the double disc, where you gotta open up multiple discs. There's three discs in this motherfucker, dude.
That kept me up until 4
o'clock. Still have it right here, because it's the fucking one of the best games ever.
And you're like, wow, where did the time go?
The reason why it's the fucking best game ever is because you fucking consume so much fucking time to beat that game. If you think Legend of Zelda or Super Mario takes time, like, this game takes commitment.
Absolutely.
It's a fucking... You're building relationships with these fucking characters and shit like that.
Kind of like my life.
I mean, you either cut them off or you let them in, right?
Absolutely.
So, Final Fantasy VII, because it was the first real... I can't say first real. That would take away from all the other Final Fantasy. It was the first big-time RPG platform for PlayStation 1. And that's where I'll fucking set that. It takes a game of commitment, time, and really just patience to understand what the fuck is going on. If you know Final Fantasy VII, then you love
no
that
life.
Game. It's fucking beautiful. The biggest part for me for Final Fantasy VII was the protagonist. It's Cloud Strife, dude. The guy with the big sword, like... Everything was against him, and he fucking managed a way, or you found a managed to fucking fight everybody off and to win that game at the end. There's so many parts to the puzzle. There's so many different things to get into. The world is massive. It was 10 times the size of fucking Mario. It was 30 times the size of Legend of Zelda. This was the game to play when you're playing games in fucking PlayStation 1 world.
And everybody out there thinking that they play games...
I play
you
games,
just got
dude.
You just got schooled right now.
So I know most people don't know what RPG means, but RPG means role playing game. So you're playing a role. You're filling in a role. Like you're playing. You are Mario. Instead of like playing as Mario, you are Mario. You get to contradict where fucking Mario goes, where Mario comes from, what he does in this fucking massive world of interactions, bosses, fights, different levels, different strategies. You can have the highest level in this game, but you're going to lose every match if you don't know how to strategically fight every boss.
And I think that's kind of, it's interesting that you say that, because thank you for explaining RPG to our audience, because, you know, some people don't, and I don't want to say me included, but I think until you explained it, I actually got it. But that's fantastic. All right, so let's go to number 4.
Okay.
What's number 4?
Okay, so going down the timeline,
Damn, you're ready for this.
Fucking PlayStation, right? So the same thing that came along with PlayStation was its biggest fucking contributor, not contributor, but its biggest thing to deal
title?
With was N64. Nintendo versus Sony was the biggest thing that happened in fucking the early 2000s, right, late 1990s.
Right, and Nintendo lost.
And Nintendo did lose, but what Nintendo had was our longevity of us playing the Super Nintendo. So when you're coming on, like, PlayStation never had the pre-PlayStation, but Nintendo always had its Nintendo, the Super Nintendo, and the N64.
And they have those titles. They have those old titles.
Exactly.
That, like, they
so
still love,
the first multiplayer game to ever come out, and I can feel like everybody would love this shit, was 007 GoldenEye. Everybody had a piece of that shit. Everybody was getting good, or everybody was doing something.
Probably made more money than the movie.
The reason why 007 was so big was because right now I'm playing multiplayer games, and that was the biggest multiplayer game to ever happen before anything.
Really?
Ever 007?
Before.
007 was the first game you could play four people at one time. So you can put four people on one screen, we could all battle, and if you win, you beat your fucking friends. The biggest thing to had ever happened before, like, any sort of online movements or anything like that happened. GoldenEye was big. It wasn't about, like, you killing somebody.
It
was
about the way they distributed the
exactly,
the
man. So if you can fit four people on one screen, then it's massive.
Wow, fast forward to here.
I'm going to progress a little bit forward. Like, this isn't one of my favorite games. It definitely is, but top five, I don't know if I would put it. But Halo would be nothing if it weren't for 007.
Wow.
The whole four-person screen, like, Halo was massive. Like, I have lots of love towards Halo because it initiated everybody to do what we're doing right now.
Mm-hmm.
The streaming platform, all the biggest things that we're doing right now, like, that's what it's about.
Exactly, and we're seeing that already just when we're talking about the podcast. Because, by the way, Octi and his podcast will be coming out. I'll be the co-host on that. It'll be coming out, and we're going to be streaming it live all the time through Twitch and through YouTube on the What's Play
exactly,
channel.
Guys. And it's going to be not about just one game, but what's new in games, how's Call of Duty doing, what's the state in Overwatch, what are the coolest skins in Fortnite, what are we doing with, like, you know, like, what are certain controller aspects? What's the best controller to use? What kind of camera should you be using on your digital streams? What's the best streaming app to use? What's the fucking weather like, even? Fuck. Like, how am I feeling that day? Like, what kind of music do I like? Everything. Like, whatever you're into is what we're going to be talking about.
Absolutely. Absolutely. All right. Well, we got four out of the five. We got one last one. Come on,
right.
I have to bring it home.
I feel like I'm negating my latest console fucking shit.
Yeah, you are a little bit.
I pay attention to, like, all the newest games, but, like, I like to give people a feedback on where I came from. The latest game that I'm going to touch on is, I'm sure, like, if anybody's watching my stream, because I see people are watching me on Mixer right now, people are watching us on stream, people are watching us on Facebook Live, I have to put this one in, because everybody knows me from this game, and this game is called Overwatch, and it's my fucking favorite fucking game ever. I love, not to put anything away, because I have a lot of viewers that watch me on Fortnite. I love Fortnite.
Just,
like,
kidding, viewers on Fortnite.
My fucking most favorite game right now is probably Fortnite, but Overwatch is, like, where I started this love for streaming and, like, competitive gaming. Overwatch is the best game you've never played. Overwatch has 30 fucking million fucking players right now, and this game is 3 years old.
So, right? Basically our audience right now.
The audience is huge. Yeah.
Kidding. No, we love everybody out there. I'm just kidding.
Don't take anything from Fortnite, because we are going to have a Fortnite discussion, and that's coming, and that's, like, the big thing right now, and I love it. Like, everybody knows that I love it. All my Fortnite friends hate the fact that I play fucking Fortnite, but I
do. That's so weird.
But let me tell you, let's not
talk
about why we don't like
you guys
Fortnite.
Are very judgmental bunch.
Overwatch is the fucking best game around right now, because it's the most competitive 6v6 shooter that changes every fucking 2 months. If somebody's strong in Overwatch, then they're gonna fucking nerf them fucking 1 month later. That's why I like Overwatch. There's fucking 30 characters to play from. Everybody does their own thing. It brings so many ass. I've met fucking hundreds of people through Overwatch, dude. Like, I meet countless amounts of people, like, friends that I will literally talk to for the next 15 years I've met through Overwatch. And, like, you build relationships through that. And the reason why I like it is because it fucking, it makes something out of nothing, my dudes. Like, you have somebody that you have, you don't know anything about. Like, I don't know anything about these people, but we know each other, like, as best friends through Overwatch. And so, that is majestic.
So, Overwatch, if you're listening, he just gave you so much love. It's time for you
Jeff
guys to
Kaplan. Jeff Kaplan, talk to me, dude. Sponsor me. We'll talk about it.
There you go. And it's time for you guys to show us a little bit of love. Just
I love you, bro.
Just give us a little bit of love. Let's play games. Back. All right, so in saying that, well, thank you, Octi, for saying... I wonder how many people went down that same journey that you went down.
Yeah, man. I mean, it starts somewhere, and you build something out of nothing, and as long as you got something going on, then we're here. We're ready to play. We're
absolutely. Ready to fucking wow. No pun now. Intended. No pun
hey,
intended.
Hey, what's the play? Check out the t-shirt right here. Beep. Yeah, super clean design, by the way.
Thank you. Might well, be- let's give love to our designer, Steve Miller. He designed the... But he's also on the patent for or the trademark for this.
That's our boy. We couldn't do it without him, man.
Thank you, Steve Miller.
Yo, Stevie boy, thank you.
So, you answered almost every one of my questions with answer number one. So what I'm
no, keep it going. I'll dissect it.
I got you. So basically, though, what did get you into online gaming?
Online gaming most likely started with to put something into the fucking trademark right now. Black Ops 4 just came out, and I'm waiting to pick it up. I'm, like, hoping to pick it up, like,
yeah,
after
what,
this
what,
conversation.
What really got what, you into, like, what was the
I'm
game?
Saying,
okay.
The first game that brought me into internet gaming was Halo.
Wow.
Halo was the one to get everybody into.
Right.
Before internet gaming started, it started with console sharing. Like, you would go over console LAN parties. You'd go over to your friend's house. Everybody would bring their Xbox. We'd have four TVs and we'd be rocking this shit out. Like,
we had a little headset.
Little headset. It started off with MP3, like little fucking Bluetooth headsets and shit like that. Now we're like rocking like big time headsets, like stereo sound, 100% fucking full time audio.
And it's only going to get bigger.
What progressed after Halo was Call of Duty, man. As soon as Call of Duty came out, it was big.
Absolutely.
I'm talking like PlayStation 2, Call of Duty, going over to my friend's house. We're all sitting in line waiting to fucking play this game.
Guys who've never picked up guns before.
Guys who've never picked up guns, waiting to go to this desert fucking Atlantis, like fucking certain fucking planet that you've never been to.
Yeah, that's dope.
You know what I've heard in my life, and I'll quote this shit 1,000 times, is with video games, you've lived 1,000 lives. Just like you've lived 1,000 lives. You've lived this life 100 times, but in different planets and different situations. Like you can either sit.
But what if you have? But what if you have the code? You might have 2,000 lives.
Right. Hey, let's play games on Facebook, baby. What's good? Or if you're Mario, yeah, you're just gonna eat green mushrooms. Your whole fucking.
Isn't that weird? Some Italian plumbers eating green mushrooms. I don't even know.
Mustaches, guys. I gotta ask you a question.
Mustache rides for free. What? What are you talking about?
No, must ask you a question.
Oh, okay. Oh, I must ask you. Oh, yeah. Shit. Wow. I'm really into my questions.
Steven's my man, dude.
Shit, I just got lost in my questions. I'm like a real reporter right here. So anyways, Octi.
What's up, brother?
Do you have any advice for the new up-and-comer young gamers out there?
I do, actually.
Wow, fantastic.
It's a big time to be alive in the world of video games right now, guys. Like, right now is the biggest time to be doing anything, virtual media, social media, video games in general. If you're playing video games and you're good at video games, you know what you're doing.
Come on to what's play.
Me? Exactly. Come talk to us. That's a suggestion towards people that are good at video games. People that are coming into video games, like, I feel like this is podcast worthy. Like, we could have multiple podcasts on me letting people know strategies or fucking certain characters to pick in fucking Overwatch. I can tell you where to fucking land in Fortnite. I can tell you how to stay alive more in Fortnite. I can tell you so many different things. But my advice isn't going to be on, like, how to get better. My advice is going to tell you guys one thing.
Let's hear it.
The video game industry is as big as it can be right now. You can literally lift off and blow across the planet doing what you fucking love. And what I'm about is, if you love something, if you're about something, and you're ready to take off, commit to it and go for it 100%. Because big time. If you're really committed to what you're doing, then go for it. Like, you know, like, young streamers, not even streamers, just young video game enthusiasts, learn how to create video games. Learn how to fucking edit. Learn how to fucking mix. Learn how to create your own widgets, your own microphone sounds, your own webcams, your own positions, all stuff like that.
and then learn all that.
We're just
and then
tapping
come on over
in.
To What's to Play Games.
Come over to What's to Play Games because we're just tapping in, guys. This is the beginning
Absolutely.
Of something that's going to be massive.
Massive.
This is ESPN has video games on it almost as much as it has fucking sports now. And like, we get a lot of hate, but you got to understand that video games is what's been happening. It's what's going to happen in the future. If you're a fucking, like, putting shit into perspective,
mm-hmm.
like,
that's it.
If you're a fucking person who can't fucking use their legs, but want to be good at, like, football, you're going to put a fucking controller in your hand and be good as you can at Madden. Madden has fucking a huge client base. If you want to skateboard and you're not good at skateboarding, like, if you can't skateboard or you're, like, you can't, you know, you're not able to use, like, a certain mm-hmm. fucking part of your body,
mm-hmm.
dude, get on that fucking skateboard on the fucking video game. You're going to be better than most people. Like,
yeah, that's beautiful.
You have the ability to be anybody, like I said earlier, you can live 1,000 lives playing video games,
mm-hmm.
but all you need to do is have the imagination for it.
Absolutely. And you know what's crazy about that? You answered, like, all of my questions almost, except for a couple other ones here.
Mm-hmm.
You pretty much answered, because my other question was going to be, what makes you different from other
games? No, that's not, but
what I'm saying is your philosophy.
Mm-hmm.
Because I don't really think that people who are playing games really understand why they're playing games or whatnot, but you've actually taken the time
mm-hmm.
and you've actually sat there like, what, you know, how does this relate to real life? How does this, you know, relate to my life?
Exactly.
And so that, and you're a little deeper of thought in
mm-hmm.
it than actual, you know, I sit here, I play games, I have robot legs and I sit in my robot chair.
Yeah.
You know what I mean? Like, you're actually trying to like think about this. How can, and it's fascinating that we met because our whole existence as a company is to try and help people throughout their life.
Mm-hmm.
So it's kind of like you're actually telling people exactly how to, you know, think about things and
yeah.
think about why
just put
why
your
are
shoulders
you
put, up. Put your shoulders up, put your chin up,
down
and
about.
The day is going to be fucking amazing, guys. We have the world outside of us. The sun is up and the fucking, the ceiling is as high as you want to fucking reach, guys.
Bust through that bitch.
Let's go.
All right. So we also have a couple more questions. Just two more, everybody. Let's see, what do we got here?
By the way, if anybody has questions on Mixer, on Facebook Live, on
yeah,
Twitter,
where is
ask
everybody?
Us,
Jesus
ask
Christ.
Us what's going on right now.
Only Jimmy?
Jimmy? We got a couple of people.
We got a couple of people. Yeah. We'll answer your questions just one moment, but I have another couple of questions here. Like, okay, so you versus other streamers,
okay.
right? What's the difference?
So basically, guys, everybody comes from, like, a certain point of life, right? And my thing is, like, everybody is their own individual. Like, I think this question strung in from, like what's different from me than other type of, like, viewers and other, I mean, other type of
streamers
and stuff
yeah.
like that.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, and, dude, I come from my own fucking life, you know? I grew up doing what I like to do. I'm a musician. I'm a guitar player first. Let me break it down for you guys, because I feel like I can break this down real quick.
Okay.
I grew up playing music. I'm a blues artist. I love playing music. My
I'm
first
a jazz
love
artist first.
Was fucking music. I love playing guitar. I love just, like, implementing that into my lifestyle. Like,
well,
I
there's so much
guitar.
Creativity in blues, like, or the ability to change on the dime. Or,
exactly.
You know what I mean? Like, you
and
can
the
do...
fact that blues has been played for so many years, but literally it can be different every single time. Like,
mm-hmm.
blues, I can... If you want me to summarize blues down into one fucking word, it's emotion. How do you feel at that certain time? Like, instead of expressing yourself with singing or, like, writing in a journal, like, just bend that note really hard until you feel that fucking certain note.
And like, the ability to pivot, too, on a, like, in 1 second.
Exactly.
You know?
Switch off in, like, a certain type of rhythm. A
it's not
tempo.
It's not just structured.
Yeah.
You know, verse, chorus, verse. Excuse me.
So,
Jesus.
Music, just the lifestyle of me, like, loving just, like, certain vibes. Like, I can literally live my life through a couple notes and I'll be happy. Also, I came from a time that, like, video games weren't really, like, the biggest thing in the world. Like, I learned how to play video games on a fucking 2-button controller and a 4 fucking arrow fucking controller, you know what I'm
saying?
Those
are hard times.
Big times. So I like, things when, like, dial-up or, like, the internet weren't, like, the fucking thing, you know? Like, you had to press *69 to call somebody back if you're really about that fucking lifestyle. Just the influence, the rawness. The second love of my life was skateboarding. Like, I grew up skateboarding. I still skateboard to this day, man. Like, I'm a fucking huge enthusiast on Thrasher, fucking Transworld, anything skateboarding. Like, I live my life through that shit. I'm fucking...
So, how does that make you different, though?
Because I feel like
I'm sure there's a lot of people out there that say, I skateboard too.
Yeah, but I feel like I come from a different type of lifestyle. I'm not a gamer, dude. When, like, people see me, they're like, you're a gamer. I'm like, no, you're an individualist. You're, like, a musician, a skateboarder, so many things before you started, like, really committing your life to video games and stuff like that. And honestly,
But like you said, you only go to win. Or, I don't want to say to win, but to be the best you can be. And if you know what, if you're the best you can be and you lose, then so be it.
Yeah. Right? And part of playing video games is understanding the facts to lose. And I know people are watching me on Mix right now, and they're probably like people that I play video games with. Mm-hmm. And they know that, like, I'm only trying to make them better. I'm never criticizing people. It might be hard on people, but I'm here to make people better. And I'm here to make people understand that they're worth their fucking knowledge in this fucking video.
Absolutely. Because everybody can add one little thing that maybe, you know, you were missing. Mm-hmm. Or, you know, just when you think you know it all, you don't know nothing.
And the part about these video games that we're playing now, unless you're playing, like, solos on Fortnite, where it's really just up to you, it's a team-based game. We're not playing these games where it's just an individual state of mind. Like, it's you versus everybody else.
Right.
Like I said, unless you're playing Fortnite solos.
Okay, well, in saying that, that goes to my other question here, is you versus everybody else, what would you say? Controller, if you're playing, like, off the Xbox, or if you're going into, which pretty much everybody does, is play through their computer.
Exactly.
Mouse and keyboard
so
status.
Getting on the controllers versus MK fucking category, which is mouse and keyboard, for anybody who doesn't know.
MK, everybody.
Yeah, MK is mouse and keyboard, and anybody who's playing mouse and keyboard is going to have an advantage towards you. The way you can flick from a controller is nowhere near how much you can flick with a fucking mouse pad left to right. The sensitivity factor is, like, throughout this world, like, it's through the rooftop. You can do so much more with the keyboard and mouse than you can with the controller.
That's what I've been told.
Even if you turn your sensitivity up to 1,000, it's not going to fucking make a difference.
Really?
People who play on MK are going to have 1,000 times more fucking of an advantage towards anybody who's playing on controller.
Well, surprise, surprise.
Here you come. Yeah. I've been smashing people on Fortnite with controller for so fucking long, man. Like, I played against the best. I played against, like, people, like, who literally, like, will message me, like, are you playing MK? And I'm like, no. And they're like, let's one-on-one. Like, wanting to 1v1 me at the end of the day because they think I'm playing MK.
So it's kind of like you're going to a gun battle with a knife.
Exactly. And if you're coming out of that battle as the winner, then you know that you just have a class.
Let's get a round of applause for Oxy. So, wow, that's it. That's fantastic. And
but honestly, at the end of the day, it's not who's faster. It's about who's smarter and who's more knowledgeable about what's going to happen. Mm-hmm. There's a thing called game sense, and I talk to all my people like, dude, I don't coach people. I don't like the word coaching, but I try to teach people the game all the fucking time when I'm playing. And I'm like, hey, you need to do this a little bit more. You might need to do this a little bit more. Mm-hmm. But the one thing that will set you apart from, I don't care how fast your mouse moves, I don't care fucking how slow your controller moves, the one thing that's going to separate you from everybody else is game sense. And that's knowing what's going to happen before it happens.
And you could actually say that in life.
Exactly, yeah. Like, predicting movements. Like, knowing what's going to happen. Like, I don't need to make a mistake in order for me to know it's fucking wrong. You know what I'm
saying? Absolutely, absolutely.
Like, I don't need to go out there and fucking prove myself wrong without... Like,
because you're observing.
Experience, yeah.
Experience, and you're observing other people. Mm-hmm. And so, people don't really realize, like, every kind of fuck-up or every kind of great accomplishment that other people do... Maybe you should just maybe take that and put that in the old memory file.
Exactly, man. And hey, it's a hard drive, baby. We're in it for a minute, right?
All right. So, last question.
Are we going to end?
Then we'll move on to what we're about to be doing. Okay. But what are your future plans for gaming? Do you see the world under Octi's eyes?
Honestly,
how do you see it?
I've never been more excited about video games than I am right now. I literally wake up every single day and, like, I look forward to playing video games. And I go to bed, like, wanting to play video games. And the reason why, not only because I have this fucking amazing company behind me right now and I know we're doing big things and we're ready to get shit launched out, but because video games are at its biggest point that it's ever been. I don't like the word peak because peak means you're never gonna go higher.
Right. Hey, but the only way to go is down.
Yeah, exactly. But we're at the biggest point where we need to be right now. Like, Overwatch is massive. Fortnite, it's huge. The newest game is fucking Call of Duty. Like, dude, we have so many fucking outlets to go through, man. We just need the surge to fucking get it in. And there's so many people playing. There's so many people arriving. Like, people are just getting introduced to Twitch, Mixer, fucking whatever we're doing, Facebook Live, like Instagram groups, like whatever we need to do to get this shit going. And it's right now, it's not even fucking as big as it's going to be in the next couple years.
Because what we're going to try to do is we're going to try to integrate everybody with us and change the script. And we're not going to go into more detail than that, but
just know that we have big things coming. But we got to keep it under wraps because we don't want people fucking looting.
Because otherwise, you know, we know that everybody out there,
people would be taking
our I was gonna say, I know everybody out there is a bunch of honest people that listen to this, but there's a couple of you in.
You want to do it.
Well, Octi, man, it's so, it's such a pleasure, man, being here in your house, and this is going to be the ground zero for all the What's the Play
all
games
the
that
podcasts,
be coming out.
Exactly. Right.
Not just podcasts, but our live streams.
Everything, guys.
Either through Twitch or also you're doing through Mixer.
Yep. Mixer's good. Xbox, I got to support my Xbox peeps. Honestly, guys, I'm probably going to be on PC soon. I'm going to get in contact with this guy. We're going to get something going. We're going to build a fucking huge PC fucking platform, and we're going to get shit at the top. Because I know everybody's like, yo, like, you play on Xbox. Like, I know you're beating everybody, but you're playing on Xbox. Like,
doesn't matter. But doesn't that make you a disadvantage,
It makes me at a disadvantage, and I'm still beating everybody. But people want to see you play on MK, and it's like, that's fine, dude. Like, oh, like, I have so many people on Xbox that I fucking love, and I built friendships, and they followed me, and I follow them, and we're supporting each other, and they're contributing towards the fact, like, what's the play games? They know what the fuck is going on. They're tuning into the live stream. They're tuning into everything. So you got to support the people that supported you. But eventually, we're getting on PC and we're dominating that fucking race because they think they're better than we are.
Really?
Yes.
Is that tough?
It's like that, dude.
Well, you know what the quote, I don't know if it's a quote, but my grandfather told me, you know, there's a difference between arrogance and confidence, right? Mm-hmm. Arrogance, you think you're the best. Mm-hmm. And confidence, you know you're the best. Mm-hmm. And I think that sums it up.
The silent assassin.
And that sums it up for you right here.
Yeah. It's a beautiful way to be alive, and honestly, man, I don't strive to be on PC, but I know people say you're not good unless you play PC.
So wow.
My waters are, like, they're boiling, and they want to be tested, because I know I'm good. I know I'm good at what I do.
Well,
like,
maybe it's the Octi Challenge today.
I'm down.
And we have them come, and we make sure to see which one.
I
think so. That's a challenge. I think it's like,
I like it.
Who's going to get, yeah, actually.
Who's up towards it? Let's go. 1v1. Let's
get it. Shout out to everybody out there with their PC. You can take that thumb or finger, index finger.
Yeah.
Shove up your ass. Octi's going to, I'm just kidding.
Let them know what's good.
That's right. But any young gamer out there that wants to maybe learn some tips or whatnot, Octi's going to be giving them to you, and you can reach him at?
Guys, you can reach me at twitch.com/dayspacedream. You can reach me on Instagram at _spaceodyssey, or you can look me up on Facebook if you want to send me like a personal message or something. I'm always willing to give somebody some advice. We're here for each other, guys. We're not here to just like balance shit out.
But more than anything, though, they can also hit you up too under Facebook slash What's Play Games, and then also twitch.tv What's Play Games.
Honestly, if you guys were to hit me up on What's the Play Games on Facebook, because I'm moderating all that shit, and I'm basically like I'm there
taking
for
over.
You guys. Yeah, it's a platform. What's the Play Games is like we're here for everybody, dude. We're here for, like, contributing towards, like, if you have any questions on anything, if you want to know what kind of controller settings to put out, what kind
Absolutely.
Of, like, Overwatch fucking content you need, what kind of Fortnite, like, where to drop. If you're not doing good in Fortnite, dude, hit me up. I'll play games with you, and we'll fucking
win that?
Games together.
Do you hear that?
Like, I'm here for you guys. Like,
that is amazing.
I'm willing to play games with you guys. Like,
is Ninja throwing that out there,
boom,
too?
Boom.
No, he's not. Octi is.
Let's go. I mean, I have over 100 wins this season. I'm sitting at the top of every part of solos, guys. Like, if you guys want something to do with something good and you want to progress, you're not that far away. Just reach us out. I mean, reach out to us and let us know.
Absolutely, because that's what we're here to help society, because there's enough social media that wants to shit on you, mm-hmm. enough social media that wants to take every little piece of you and like get upset about one little thing you said. We're the absolute opposite, and we're here with Octi, who's willing to give his knowledge, willing to give. And you know what? You'll probably learn from a couple people on along the way. I mean, that's the way the world works.
I agree.
Yeah. Well, thank you very much, Octi. It's been a fucking pleasure.
Yeah, man. Jesus Christ. Honestly, it's been a good time. I wish this podcast could go on like 1,000 more.
You
minutes,
want to go on for 4 more hours? Just like Twitch does. Because there is a lot of streaming going on in Twitch.
There is, man. But, I mean, something that takes us away from everything else is just being raw, being real, being here for everybody else, and letting people know that we're right there with them, you know?
Absolutely. It's been a pleasure, Octi. On that note, thank you so much.
Love you guys.
Thanks.
No matter what we face, we must face the moment of truth, baby.
They say it's lonely at the top in whatever you do. You always gotta watch motherfuckers around you. Nobody's invincible, no plan is foolproof. We all must meet our moment of truth. The same shiesty cats that you hang with and do your thing with could set you up and wet you up. Nigga, peep the language, it's universal. You play with fire, it may hurt you or burn you. Lessons are blessings you should learn through, let's face facts. Although MCs lace tracks, it doesn't mean behind the scenes there ain't no dirt to trace back. That goes for all of us, there ain't nobody to trust. It's like sabotage, it's got me ready to bust. But I can't jeopardize what I've done up to this point, so I'ma get more guys to help me run the whole joint. Cultivate, multiply, motivate, or else we'll die. You know I'll be the master of the who, what, where, and why. See, when you're shining, some chumps will wanna dull ya. Always selfish, jealous punks will wanna pull ya down, just like some shellfish in a bucket, cause they love it to see your ass squirm like a worm. But just as you'll receive what is coming to you, everybody else is gonna get this too. I ain't no saint, therefore I cannot dispute that everyone must meet their moment of truth. Actions have reactions, don't be quick to judge. You may not know the hardships people don't speak of. It's best to step back and observe with coup, for we all must meet our moment of truth. Sometimes you gotta dig deep. When problems come near, don't fear. Things get severe for everybody, everywhere. Why do bad things happen to good people? Seems that life is just a constant war between good and evil. The situation that I'm facing is mad amazing. To think such problems can arise from minor confrontations. Now I'm contemplating in my bedroom pacing. Dark clouds over my head, my heart's racing. Suicide? Nah, I'm not a foolish guy. Don't even feel like drinking or even getting high, cause all that's gonna do really is accelerate the anxieties that I wish I could alleviate. But wait, I've been through a whole lot of other shit before, so I ought to be able to withstand some more. But I'm sweating though, my eyes are turning red, and yo, I'm ready to lose my mind, but instead I use my mind. I put down the knife and take the bullets out my nine. My only crime was that I'm too damn kind, and now some scandalous motherfuckers wanna take what's mine. But they can't take the respect that I've earned in my lifetime, and you know they'll never stop the furious force of my rhymes. So like they say, every dog has its day, and like they say, God works in a mysterious way. So I pray, remembering the days of my youth, as I prepare to meet my moment of truth. Truth. Yo, I got one lyric pointed at your head for start. Another one is pointed at your weak ass heart. Now if I pull the trigger on these fully loaded lines, you're gonna wish I would've pulled a black nine. I'm Mac Dimes, crack the spines of the fake gangsters. Yeah, the biting trifling niggas and the studio pranksters. Yo, looking at the situation plainly, will you remain G, or will you be looked upon strangely? I reign as the articulator with the greater data, revolving on a task and much doper than my last jam. While others struggle to juggle tricky metaphors, I explore more to expose the core. A lot of MCs act stupid to me, and we have yet to see if they can match our longevity. But anyway, it's just another day, another fake jack I slay with my spectacular rap display. Styles smooth but rugged, you can't push or shove it. You dig it and you dug it, cause like money you love it. The king of monotone with my own throne, righteously violent prone. My words bring winds like cyclones, storming your hideout, blocking out your sunlight. Your image and your business were truly not done right. Throw up your hiala now, divine saviors. You got no hand skills, there's no security to save you. No pager, no celly, no drop top Benzy. I came to bring your phony hip hop to an end. My art of war will leave you sore from the abuse, cause you must meet your moment of truth. They say it's lonely at the top in whatever you do. You always gotta watch motherfuckers around you. No one is untouchable, no man is bulletproof. We all must meet our moment of truth. True, true.
To the Who Cares, Paul.